plants convert some of the sun's energy into vegetation. The first law of thermodynamics says that energy cannot be created or destroyed. It has to go somewhere. So the energy in the plants can be decomposed. It can be lost as heat as the plant does work, as it grows. Or it can be eaten by herbivores, as here, as you can see here. So because some of the energy is lost as decomposition and heat, only a certain amount is passed on to the next layer. And then the caterpillars that are eating this may then be consumed by songbirds. And again, the same principles apply. Some of the caterpillar energy is lost as heat as they do work, as they grow. Some is lost as the caterpillars die and decompose, but some of it is passed on, say, to songbirds. And then the next layer, the songbirds may be eaten by hawks, but some of the songbird energy is lost as they do work. Some is lost as they die and decompose, and only a certain amount is passed on to the hawks. So we have a food chain of plants, caterpillars, songbirds, hawks, and the energy is reduced with each layer, say by 90%. Furthermore, as animals move up the food chain, they also need to be larger and fiercer in order to capture their prey. So the caterpillars are feeding on the plants, the songbirds are quelling the caterpillars, the hawks are then feeding on the songbirds. And if you think about it, the large, scary animals are top predators. Think of killer whales or lions. And of course, there are exceptions to this. Think of the tiny insects that eat their prey from the inside. So in each layer, there's less energy. And each layer, the animals have to be larger. So it follows that there'll be fewer animals. So there'll be lots of caterpillars, smaller numbers of songbirds, very few hawks. And this is called the Eltonian pyramid of numbers, named after Charles Elton, the pioneering ecologist. And food chains tend to be quite short, and they're constrained by the energy. If 90% of the energy is lost in each layer, it's difficult then to be a predator of hawks and still be sustainable. Also, as animals get larger as they move up the food chain, the next layer would have to be larger still. Again, serious problems. The story I've described here is simplified. In reality, there's a whole range of different herbivores, not just caterpillars. There might be aphids, there might be leaf miners, there might be deer. So really, this is a web of interconnected food chains. So the first law of thermodynamics and the concept that consumers have to be larger to quell their dinner has a number of conclusions. It says that the numbers of animals decline as you move up the food chain. It says that food chains will be short and that big, fierce animals are scarce.